Hi everyone, Sanbonani Dumelang Luchani. Here's what happened on Muvango, November 2020. Mukondereli tells Bomasindi that Mpo is pregnant and Masindi doesn't believe her because of what Mulimisi said about Mpo and demanded proof. But Mukondereli said she doesn't need to have a proof and she's always never wrong about these things. Mpo is glowing. That can only mean one thing, that she's pregnant. She also told Masindi to be happy and celebrate because she's been waiting for this for so many years, and Azwindini is going to be a dad. And the way she was so excited, guys, she wanted to give Bomasindi a hug, but Masindi wouldn't let her because of corona. Rendani told her husband that her ego was still bruised and her hubby apologized for it, and then she suggested that they should open a joint account, but Hulisani wasn't happy about that idea. But Rendani convinced him though, even though he agreed, but he didn't like the idea. Mpo visited Masindi and Mkondereli just to check them up since there's a corona outbreak and brought them food. Masindi told her she appreciated her visit as they were bored. She gave her a list for inauguration, but Mpo said she must just send it via WhatsApp. Then Mkondereli noticed that Teboho and Mulalo were not on the list and insisted that they should be invited. But as soon as Mkondereli left the room, Masindi told Mpo not to invite Teboho and Mulalo because they might mess up the ceremony and they are always scheming. Rendani's mother was very livid and grabbed Rendani and asked her that how could she pay for her own lobola because it's a taboo. But Rendani told her that it's a 21st century, it's okay. She was so angry that Rendani lied to her. Then she told Rendani that Hulisani is just a boy, he's not a man. Then Randy told her mother that it's enough and left her standing at Dugatoli. Mpo was angry when she saw that Buchilo's list, because he also included a DJ, and Buchilo told her that he wanted to make a statement, but Mpo told him it's not within the budget. And then Azwindini stepped in while they were arguing about the DJ. Then Mpo left because she wanted to throw up and locked herself in the bathroom. Azwindini reprimanded Buchilo for disrespecting Mpo and asked him to apologize. And then Buchilo apologized and told Mpo that it's fine even if there's no DJ. Hulisani came to see Rendani's mother and asked her about the tap that he fixed, if it was fine, but Mahangwane said yes and she gave him a cold shoulder. As Mpo was busy preparing for inauguration, she asked Buchilo that why the sudden change of heart, because he wanted a DJ, told her to leave him alone. Mpo informed Buchilo that they shouldn't fight because she ended things with his uncle. Buchilo said he won't let that happen. Bosuzane visited Teboho and asked if Teboho could help in looking after Mkondeleri and Masindi. Teboho didn't want to, but Mulalo said she will take care of them. Susan shouldn't worry. But Teboho said she's scared of the disease. Rendani's husband was cooking for Rendani and she was so happy about it. And then Hulisani asked Rendani if he has done something wrong because her mother was very moody and gave him a cold shoulder earlier on. Then Rendani responded and said, it's nothing big, maybe she was stressed about something. Teboho visited Mkondereli and Masindi and she was wearing all the PPEs you could think of and then sanitized everything including a door and then gave them food and quickly left. Later on, Suzani came and wanted to test them and they were not happy about it. Azwindini complained about a list and said it was too long. And Mpo said it was her mother insisted that everyone on that list should be invited. And Makati asked why Mulalo and Teboho not on the list. Mpo said Bomasindi told her that they were not welcome, so they shouldn't be included. And then Makati made a decision that they should be included because they are family. Mahangwane and Chess packed their bags as they were ready to go to Venda. Then Hangwane was on the phone call with Gizara and then she told him that there was something bothering her. She will tell Gizara when they get to Venda. But Gizara insisted that she must tell him what was going on. And then Thangwani told Kizara that Rendani paid lobola for herself. Kizara was also so angry and told Thangwani that Rendani needs to divorce Hulisan immediately because that guy is good for nothing. Mulalo and Teboho got the invite, but Mulalo didn't want to go to the inauguration because that would mean he accepted the defeat. Then Teboho told him that they should go because the court will ruin into their favor. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe and hit that notification button so that you can get more videos on this channel. Thank you.